So now that the NBA has moved on to their bubble format and all the players are set, in today's video we're going to talk about how some of the players have reacted to being in the bubble. But before we get started with this video, make sure you drop a like and comment your opinions down below. If you enjoyed this content, it's your boy David from NBA Knowledge. If you enjoyed the channel, hit that subscribe button and the bell to be notified after each and every single video. But the first players that we are going to talk about are Bruno Caboclo and also Richaun Holmes. So the NBA has set this rule to where you can't leave the premises at certain times or leave certain parts of the bubble. And if you do, you will be forced to quarantine. So both of these guys, of course, they broke the rules. In the case of Bruno Caboclo, when the Rockets arrived in Orlando, he broke the rules when he inadvertently left his room during the initial quarantine period after he arrived in Orlando. And then also in the case of Richaun Holmes, I believe he was going out to get something from DoorDash and he crossed the border lines. And now because of that, both of them will have to quarantine for, I believe, at least 2 weeks, which really sucks, man. I mean, imagine you're just going to get some Popeyes or something, and then you cross one line and you hear the alarms and everything. And then you're looking around and then they're like, hey, bro, you gotta go quarantine. Man, that's trifling. That sucks. And also another thing that happened is Montrezl Harrell. Montrezl Harrell had a family emergency and he had to leave the bubble, so I assume he has to do some quarantine as well. But enough of all of the people that have gotten in trouble, let's talk about the food and all of the accommodations that the players are going through. The first person that we're going to talk about is Troy Daniels. For those who do not know, Troy Daniels is just a role player, you know, spot up shooter, can give you some spacing at the guard position on the perimeter, but that's about it. He's just a role player. He was on the Lakers this year, was eventually waived, and now he is currently on the Denver Nuggets. He shared a picture of his food and his accommodations in the bubble, and man, I don't even really know what to say. It's not like the food was trash or anything, but for NBA players and the money that the NBA has, I understand they lost some money because of COVID. It looked pretty underwhelming, and he even was quoted saying, I'm just trying to give my fans and people who follow me a different outlook on what they may see otherwise. That's what we're going through in the bubble. It's not about where you're from, it's about where you're at. I've just dealt with it, the attention, and if I could do it over, I would literally do it over again. It's just something I try to share with my fans. I am a realist. And to be honest, I completely agree with him. If he wants to share what he's going through in the bubble to his fans, I have no problem with that. And honestly, when I look at the bubble, it really is just going to be about players' perspectives. If players feel like they need more than what they're being given, then they can express that. But if they feel like it's the other hand, then they can do the same thing and express those feelings as well. I also like how the NBA is to have the one and only Shaqtin' the Fool's MVP Hall of Famer, JaVale McGee. Now, for those who do not know, JaVale McGee does have a YouTube channel, and he's been keeping track of what's happening in the bubble. And shout out to him and all the other players doing so, because I don't know if any other players are doing that, but it would be pretty cool and smart for them to do so for their YouTube channels. And I appreciate it. But during his vlogs, he showed what the players are going through with the practices and all the arenas around them and the hallways and just the overall accommodations that they have. It's pretty cool. And if you want to check it out, a link will be in the description box down below. And maybe I'll throw in a little video clip at the end of this segment. But moving on to the next and final player, we have Dwight Howard. Dwight Howard has been quoted saying some very, very polarizing topics, especially at this point in time in this country, as wearing a face mask to stop the spread of COVID-19 has become a very hot topic. And honestly, I hate the fact that it is because it's so stupid. But Dwight Howard said that players should not have to wear a mask in the bubble, and this was his reasoning. He said, and I quote, they sanitize everything, Howard said. We're getting tested every day, so it's not like we're around anybody that can give it to us because we all get tested together. And so we're only around each other. We're only around everybody that's in the bubble. We don't see any outsiders. We don't have any contact with outsiders. So I understand the whole wearing mask and all that stuff. So nobody is trying to do anything out of order. But, you know, again, I understand that there always has to be some type of controversy somewhere. And I'm not in no controversy. You know what I'm saying? I get it. It's some clickbait. Honestly, I really don't know what he meant by that. I mean, I kind of get the first part, but the second part, I'm just a little confused. But I think that when he says that all of them shouldn't have to wear masks, I understand that because he's looking at it like none of us are about to leave anyways. We're all not even able to do so. And if we do, we have to quarantine. They're treating us very well here. He's looking at it like, hey, if we're all at home, why can't we feel like we're at home and make ourselves more comfortable? Well, Dwight, that's really where the argument falls apart. Because if we're being real here, not everybody is you. Everybody may not feel the same way. Some guys may say, hey, we don't know if you got corona still from even in the past, and the symptoms are just not showing. We're just not going to put anybody at risk. And even when guys will leave and have to be quarantined, when they come back, we still don't know how COVID completely works. What if they have it and the symptoms were just not detectable during their quarantine? So there are so many other factors you have to consider, and you have to look at it from a perspective that isn't your own, so you can fully be empathetic with the others that are taking this very seriously. Now, honestly, I don't think Dwight Howard is saying that he's not going to wear a mask. I just think he's more so complaining about it, and he's not even like making it a big deal. It's just something I found for this video. But that concludes it with players' reactions to the bubble. If you enjoy these kind of videos, let me know in the comment section down below. Also, do not forget to drop a like so I can keep making fire content on this channel. If you enjoy this channel, hit that subscribe button and that bell to be notified after each and every single video that I post. Shout out to all these players, man. They're really doing their AAU thing on this trip to Orlando. But this is your boy David from NBA Knowledge. Y'all stay safe out there. It's a crazy world, you know what I'm saying? And also, please, for the love of God, wear a mask. Man, I'm out, man. Y'all stay safe. Peace.